This is Roto Baller Radio on Sirius XM Fantasy Sports Radio.
We are back, Roto Baller Radio here, doing it live. And of course, we have a special guest, a guy who we're going to talk fantasy football and all kinds of fantasy sports with, our guy, Sandy Plaschke's from Owner's Box. Good day to you, sir. How are you doing this week?
I'm doing great, guys. Thanks for having me.
We are blessed to have you as well, especially on the eve of your site here, Owner's Box, starting NFL draft and app being released. So before we get to some of the fun stuff in the NFL going on right now, catch us up what's going on with Owner Box. Obviously, you guys need to check out rotoballer.com/box. Make sure you get all the details. Get in there early. I'm not even going to tease it more than that. Go check it out. Sandy, take it away here.
Yeah, we just opened up NFL drafts. All our contest sizes are available. It's really exciting. Obviously, fantasy football being one of my favorite fantasy sports, I'm juiced up on my end. But we just rolled out our mobile app as well, so users are free to sign up. Once they sign up, they get the mobile app right away to their email, and they can test it and download it. So that's really, really exciting on our end. But as I said, you know, fantasy football, we couldn't be more excited. Our weekly format plays extremely well to fantasy, and we take a little unique approach to it. So we really think our users will love what we're doing here.
And by the way, we're going to get into the format in a moment, but in case you just needed blind enticement out there, ladies and gents, cats and dogs and all other terrestrial beings, freebies are involved. Yes, rotoballer.com/box. You get your VIP program sign up. You get $100 credit. And oh, by the way, one in every five people that sign up for the beta program now will get a full season of Roto Ballers Premium NFL and DFS valued at $99. So yes, incentives galore plus fun gaming. We're going to be playing on this platform. Sandy, let's talk a little NFL. We're going to come back to all the games and what we have available here at Owner's Box. But, you know, the news cycle is fast and furious. And every day you look up and it seems like someone new is getting injured, or perhaps maybe it's just me. I spoke about this with Josh the other day. I feel like there's extra carnage this year. Maybe I just forgot how bad training camp is. So, you know, if you're a drafter, if you're a gamer out there, and some of these guys that maybe you were hoping would be dark horses or potentially guys that would be second or third year breakout candidates start showing up on injury reports, specifically guys like Anthony Miller and other receivers that we expected to have bigger roles potentially in their offense as time moved on, Michael Gallups of last year, so to speak. Do you start thinking like, maybe I need to look at some of these rookie receivers a little more, even with this COVID-19 stuff and everything we're expecting? Like, how are you working out these injuries in the preseason to players who are more established?
Yeah, it's a great question. I'm already looking at, you know, early on in the season when the rookies got picked. I love CeeDee Lambs of the world, the Jerry Judys. I was already looking at some of those guys, but you know, maybe a little earlier now than you'd suspect with all these injuries at receiver, like you said. So I definitely will take a risk on a rookie guy early. I'm bullish on some of the, as I said, CeeDee Lamb and Jerry Judy, to name two of them. So I'm definitely going to take a risk there. I guess
Josh,
you wouldn't call, not really a risk, I guess you could say, but I'm definitely taking them earlier than a lot of other people.
Yeah, a risk, I guess, would be if like all of these other players weren't injured. Yeah. We're hoping that these rookies have a bigger role. But Josh, I got Denzel Mims in our Sirius XM. We have like a dynasty league here that we do, one of the many. And I also, in the rookie reserve round, I was bad last year, so I had some good picks. I also got Jerry Jeudy. Okay, so let's just talk about that for a minute. Like with these types of players, you know, specifically guys who you expect to be alphas in their offense, and definitely Sandy, I want to hear from you about this. Like Josh, are we just getting to the point in the preseason where we need to drop the whole, it was COVID-19 stuff, these guys aren't going to be ready because they don't have time to run with the first? Like, do we need to just drop that narrative and start taking guys on talent?
No. For me.
Hard no for Josh.
Straight shooter. I love it.
No, like, yeah. You can invest for sure. But, you know, have you ever, like, went to a car dealership and they say, hey, would you like to test drive the car? You're like, nah. I'm good. Just give me the papers. I'll sign, you know, like I need to see some action. And obviously it's going to be a little bit impossible, you know, minus the college tape for some of these players. But what we do have is depth charts and beat writers and, you know, practices and training camps to try to evaluate who's running with the first, second and third team, and then make your evaluation from there. Some people are going to get bumped up. Some people may, you know, be a little bit later in terms of their opportunity and when they bloom in the fantasy problem. But we see rookies break out every single year. It's only a matter of, you know, pinpointing which ones are set for early opportunity that can really break out. You know, we saw the late age breakout with AJ Brown and Terry McLaurin, where there's always usually like a few running backs that end up surprising us there as well, like that aren't the Clyde Edwards-Hillaires and companies. Maybe it's a guy like Zach Moss. So yes, I'm fine with the investment, but I don't want it to be like a make or break situation where if he doesn't perform for me, I counted on some of these rookies as starters and it could damage your fantasy team.
Talking here with Sandy Plaschke's from ownersbox.com. Sandy, how does this relate to the weekly game, right? Owner's Box is really coming through with a great product. It's a weekly kind of, you know, format for daily fantasy. And so we don't really view that in the same way. So how do these types of narratives play out, especially with the NFL game that's going to be here?
Yeah, so that's a great question, actually, and it plays very well to our format. It's not like your season-long leagues where you'd be taking a big risk, taking a rookie who you haven't seen tape on in the league. So in our format, you can draft, you know, week one, you'll have your team, and then you're able to redraft in future weeks. So if you see a rookie like Jerry Jeudy, for example, going off, you don't have to take a risk on him week one when you're not as sure that he'll perform as well. So once you get some tape on him, you see some weeks, and then you can draft him in a future draft. So the beauty of the weekly format is you're able to enter any single day of the week and start any point of the season. So as I said, you know, the rookie receivers, you'll probably take chances on later in the season, not as early on.
Talking here again with Sandy Plaschke's and ownersbox.com and rotoballer.com/box. If you want to get all the incentives and join the beta, this is looking terrific, by the way. The user interface on the site, super clean, app look clean. Josh, talk to me, man. I mean, I know there's all kinds of variety of fantasy sports to play here. We're looking at Owner's Box. You guys are offering gaming for all the right reasons, all the right sports. Josh, in the weekly game, right? Like we spoke about how it would look like if you played like monthly MLB, and they're all different format styles. But all of a sudden, when you elongate the daily format, but you don't really get into the season long, which is arduous and risky with certain player valuations, right? Don't you get to play the fantasy stock market in a more correct way? Isn't that the sample size you want, these multi-week or one-week contests where you get the kind of climate of the land, and then you could kind of figure it out again the next time you have an opportunity to draft a team? I think you may have found the sweet spot here, Sandy. And I just want to hear Josh's opinion on that, because I've honestly grown weary of the single day, small sample size fantasy sports. It's gotten a little annoying. Yeah.
Yeah. I think it, you know, this is like a happy medium for the people who don't have the bankrolls to stomach the variance from day to day. Like you can make a great lineup, but if you only have one or two lineups to fire out in DFS, you know, you're behind the eight ball from all these, you know, multiple entry tournaments, or you're like, you knew that if you, somebody was riding hot, but they had one off game, and that was the one game that you played them in your DraftKings lineup, that can be really frustrating or, you know, disappointing. So the fact that we're locking in for a full week and you can get like a true sample with some of these players, that to me is more enticing for like the daily games that you have with Major League Baseball and with NBA. So I'm pretty interested to see. I think football is going to replicate a little bit closer. Maybe Sandy can ask, you know, answer this question. Like, are we really just talking about something similar to like, you know, Thursday through Monday night football for most weeks when we're sending these lineups, or do we get any expansion on that?
Yeah. So on Tuesdays, as you said, sorry, Thursdays through Sundays, it's similar to DFS in that regard a bit. But again, you know, depending on the amount of users in the contest, we also offer multi-week tournament contests. So in some instances, it's similar in the head-to-head 2 week or 1 week, it's similar to DFS. But in other regards, when there's 4 users, 8 users, 16 users, it goes multiple weeks. So that in that regard, it's more, you know, management strategy driven, but it is similar to DFS in a single week for sure.
And by the way, I'm looking at the site. I see the games open and available. I'm checking out some of the details here. I'm ready to get started and looking at an excellent platform here with my $100 owner's bucks credit, by the way, waiting for me. So I'm going to be looking at that. Talk to us a little bit about the rest of the platform here. I know you guys have some other unique qualities to you. So kind of give us the lay of the land with owner's bucks.
Yeah, you know, what we want to do is we want to implement and coin this weekly fantasy sports as its own thing. But in addition, we really want to layer a social and gamification features on top of it, right? So if you play it on the platform, you know that there's a messenger system similar to the Facebook or LinkedIn style chat where you can chat public and privately with users all over the platform. You can start groups. You can rank amongst the groups, you know, talk smack with your friends, you know, and see who really is the best in the platform. So our whole goal is to really allow users to make the name for themselves on the platform, really have a forward-facing brand almost. So that's, you know, that's another layer on top of the weekly contest that we offer, but we really want to propel this social model on our platform for sure.
There it is. Gamers out there looking to develop a reputation at being good at the weekly fantasy sports, go ahead, get yourself some owner's box here, rotoballer.com/box. Just circling back quickly to the NFL news here. You know, the Bears, Anthony Miller had some terrific breakout games last year, but, you know, he had bad quarterbacking as well. He's now injured shoulder, not participating in team drills. He was the guy I was alluding to earlier. Nick Foles is allegedly slightly ahead of Mitch Trubisky. Sandy, can you just tell me, do you have the barf bag as close to you as I do whenever I think about how we're possibly going to turn anyone but Allen Robinson into a fantasy viable receiver here in Chicago when you have two of the most horrific quarterbacks right now starting in the NFL?
You know, I'm a huge Packers fan. This is a funny question because I actually told my buddy, I didn't even know Nick Foles was ahead of Trubisky in the quarterback race right now. I said there was no chance Trubisky would be the starter after week 9. I said that to my buddy a couple weeks ago. I think Trubisky is terrible. And as you said, Allen Robinson's a beast. Love him. You know, no matter who's his quarterback, he'll get targets. So, I mean, other than that, you said Anthony Miller's not. Is he injured? What's up?
Yeah. Right now? Got it. He has a little shoulder injury. He is participating in team drills, but I personally thought, like, if you put Anthony Miller on a team with a viable quarterback, this guy is prime for a breakout right now. If towards the end of last season, Anthony Miller made me some DFS dollars, I'll tell you that right now. So these are the types of players that now I'm looking at Denzel Mims. I'm thinking, well, maybe I'd rather have Denzel Mims than Anthony Miller's, right? I mean, these are the way the world is working right now in fantasy is crazy, but that's what I said to you, Josh, earlier. It's like, I'm not going to take the veteran who's injured right now if I can get in that same round range the upside starter who people are still snoozing on. I'm just the rookie starter is going to get drafted by me at this point at receiver. That's kind of where my mind is shifting. Talking here, one more plug for the wonderful ownersbox.com. Sandy Plashkes, thank you for joining us today. And of course, we look forward to having you guys on again. And please, I urge everyone to get involved with the beta and get your 1 in 5 chance of getting some year-long DFS content for free at Rotoballer. Also, get yourself 100 free bucks here. So, Sandy, we appreciate you again for joining us and look forward to next week as well.
Thanks, Raphael. Thanks, Josh. Always a pleasure, guys.
There it is. Sandy Plashkes, ownersbox.com. Check it out, rotoballer.com/box.